honored to be back again this year for the recognition of the Georgia Lineman Appreciation Celebration. Since these gentlemen and lady have been standing for quite a while, I will tailor my remarks accordingly. Let me just say at the outset, thanks to the members of the General Assembly who have taken the initiative to make this recognition possible. All of the elected officials, the two constitutional officers who are with us here today, to the chairman who sponsored the bill that I will be signing in just a few minutes, and to his counterpart in the Senate, Steve Hooch, for carrying this very, I think, very important piece of legislation. I too have a proclamation. It is in the middle. It appropriately recognizes why we are here. And briefly, to say to those who are behind me and the others of you in the audience who share my sentiment, we thank you for what you do on a daily basis. Not just to maintain the flow of electricity and other services, more and more, which of course are being transmitted and require that somebody be able to climb that pole in order to keep all of those other services operable as well. To those organizations, some of whom have already been recognized, who have come together to support this endeavor today, thank you. They are your employers, by the way. Thank you for the fact that they would take time to recognize the importance of what you do. The proclamation has already been appropriately framed, so I won't go over and do anything with it. We'll do it with pictures in just a few minutes. But let's talk about one of the real reasons we're here today. And that is legislation. It is House Bill 767. Chairman Powell is the author of that in the House, as I indicated. And what it does is it designates that utility service vehicles come under the coverage of what was originally the Spencer Cass Law. That means that anyone who is confronting a service vehicle is required to move over, if at all possible. If they are unable to move over and change lanes, they are required to slow down. And that, of course, is a safety feature. Nobody appreciates what these gentlemen and lady do as much as when natural disasters occur. In rural parts of our state, which is where I have lived for all of my life, when the lights go out, after a given period of time, my wife is going to say, why don't you go find out where the problem is? And I try to do that. Invariably, they are head up. They already have found the problem, and they're working on it. And so for all of us who have been in those situations of depending on electricity and it not being there, I simply say thank you on a personal level. Now, I'm going to ask the members of the General Assembly and if they would join me behind the signature table here, and I will sign House Bill 767 into law.